Albert Roussel, who came to Chittor, heard the story, went back, composed the opera, and they performed in 1933. Mm. There are so many Mandiratham films I've seen before where they were not subtitled, but I enjoyed every minute of it. The best work of my life was that opera, because I did everything that I wanted to do, and I've always wanted to do theatre. So he said, "You're Indian?" So I said, "Yeah." "So you know Devdas?" So I said, "Yeah, I know Devdas. It's a super film, it's super Shah Rukh Khan." So I said, it's 6 years down the line.
Sir, as you were Padmavati, you had this theatrical extravaganza that you had in Paris in 2008, and the film is doing extraordinarily well in France as well. There's so many videos coming out from France. People are actually loving it. They don't understand the language, but they're absolutely bowled over by the opulence and the magnificence that they see on screen. Do you feel happy about that? The way people are reacting.
But I went and directed the opera, which was written in French, and it was written in 1900 by the composer Albert Roussel, who came to Chittor, heard the story, went back, composed the opera, and they performed in 1933. When they came to me, I said, "But I don't understand his language. What is he saying? What is he saying?" So they translated for me. And I think once you come into music, once you come into a production on stage and all the choreography and the direction and all, you forget language. You start understanding everything that unfolds. There are so many Mandiratham films I've seen before where they were not subtitled, but I enjoyed every minute of it, because the filmmaker has gone beyond language and all that. He's communicating to you through so many other facets of his filmmaking. So I feel that in Paris, especially when I performed the opera, it was so wonderful an experience. And I had gone there post Savaria, which had not done well at all at the box office. I was very disturbed, and I was very in depression. And then I went and I directed, I think the best work of my life was that opera, because I did everything that I wanted to do, and I've always wanted to do theatre. But the thought lingered over in the last 8 years. It was 2008 when I did the opera. From 2008 to 2017, 8 years, I lived with the thought of wanting to make the film. So now when it's being appreciated there, and I think France has always loved my work. I've always been, Devdas has been very, very well received over there. When I went in 2008 for the opera, that's when I went to a store. Devdas had released in 2002, and I went to a small little suburban to buy something to eat. So he said, "You're Indian?" So I said, "Yeah." "So you know Devdas?" So I said, "Yeah, I know Devdas. It's a super film, it's super Shah Rukh Khan." So I said, it's 6 years down the line. Then I was walking down there, there's a theater near Champs-Élysées, and I suddenly saw the Devdas poster still kept over there. So I said, "Bloody hell, look at this." The impact after 6 years or so, it was there. Devdas had and it was very well received. So I hope Padmaavati connects. I think they connect to my work, they connect to my kind of filmmaking. They understand what I'm trying to do without bias, without trying to having to review my film and find faults in it, and etc., etc., etc.
Shabana Azmi ji, who's been, I think, an extremely vocal supporter of you throughout the entire duration, she feels that it should be Padmaavat should be India's entry to the Oscars. Javed Saab feels that this is.
Ridhun, pehle India mein to entry mil jaye, bhai. In 3 street mein to chal nahi rahi hai, bhaiya. Pehle yahan entry le le, fir wahan jaenge hum.
Yeah, but I think, you know, it's a big thing to coming from someone like her, because she's an extremely, I think she's not merely an Indian icon. She's a world icon as far as movies are concerned. And if she's saying it, then she's saying it with the definite responsibility. And it definitely means something.
Yeah, I think.
And Javed Saab has said that it is Deepika Padukone's Mother India. He has compared it to Mother India in terms of the grandeur and the scale.
Yeah. So what do you want me to say about?
Yeah. So how do you respond to that after? Because I think let's talk about the movie now. Let's talk about the movie as well, because it's phenomenal.
I love this film. I have made it from deep down my heart, which I do with all my films, but this one is a special one, because you've gone through so much and you've nurtured it like this and not allow any of those problems to reach or be seen on the screen. So that is a huge battle you fight. You have to not get distracted, so focus. All the unit came together because we were all fighting. It was not just me fighting, it was all my cinematographer, my art director, everybody was putting up a fight. Even during the last bit. So it's a very special film for all of us, where we've created it in a very, it's like how do you explain to it that a storm aa raha hai aur uske andar aap kuch kuch painting kar rahe, because you know that's the only time that I don't know how to explain the situation. There is no parallel to this situation, but it's very special for all of us. Everybody gave their best, and when you're pushed to the brink, you just emerge with all your potential that is there in you, which we normally hardly tap into ourselves. So everybody was at their best. It's a fabulous film. I think it is one of my best, because
definitely.
And forget the circumstances that you make it. It is just I was tripping. I was, even when the Jaipur, I loved my film so much. When the Jaipur attack happened, then we were physically assaulted and all that. And I went to them the next day morning. I said, you know, oh, I understand all that was wrong, but that shot we'll never get again, because that shot is what I've left over there.
Mm.
So my soul was in every shot. That is what mattered to me.
Wow.
I don't care about what was happening to me, the humiliation. I did nothing. When you make a film, you have to surrender completely. There has to be no ego. There has to be no nothing. So even if you're angry with the humiliation, you have to churn it and convert it into the film and the creative space
channelized
that you're making it. And that is what I did. That is what we all did. So it's a very special film. Javed Saab and Shabanaz Mia, I love them. I love their work.
Mm.
I love them because I don't know them very well, but I love their work. I look up to them. Javed Saab had very many nice things to say about the film. And I normally wait for these two or three people who would give me their opinion on the film. And he was completely enamored by the film. So was Shabanaz ji. And yeah, so if they think that this is the film that needs to get its place wherever, in the world of cinema, wherever it has to find its place, it's a nice feeling. It's a
right.
nice thought that
right.
at least they're endorsing something that has been on a film that has never been made before. I think every department is so brilliant.
100%.
My actors are so brilliant.
Yeah.
They're so fabulous. All my actors, just from the top right till the last junior artist, is brilliant.
Bilkul.
So I just feel that they've all given their best. This
right.
film should be celebrated, not attacked. This film should now be shown in this country without fear. No art should be connecting with politics and all that. Let people enjoy it. Let people celebrate it. Let Rajasthan see this film
right.
and say it is our glory. The world is seeing the film. The world is appreciating. But jinke bare mein kahi gayi hai kahani, the people who I am glorifying or talking about or respecting through my work or telling the world that this is a great story that needs to be seen. You've heard it in your parents telling the story or textbooks because you've read it in school. But now you're seeing it. But the other ones were not seeing it. So it's sad. But
people are traveling into different states to watch the film.
That is true.
They're watching. It's become like tourism part. People are actually. So talking about, you talk about the art part of it. I think there's so much to discuss. One scene that immediately comes to my mind is that when Khilji is facing Mongols, and that entire sand, that entire effect, the way it is created, and when he just goes into that's beautifully stunts. That's beautifully. I've never seen something like that.
Yeah.
How did you conceptualize that?
Sean Kaushal was there, we were all there, Prasad VFX, the person who's doing our VFX played a great part in it.
Right.
It was one of the most beautifully conceived pieces by Sean Kaushal. It was just beautifully done, and it had no action.
Right.
It had no action, because action doesn't mean that you have to show two people
yeah,
fighting
that's
and people striking swords at each other. Wars are fought here also.
Right.
So there were so many such things in the film which today you can pull it off because there is a great backing of VFX also. And,
yeah.
and now everybody, all the departments can think a little more freely and say, can we do this, can we do that? Because that could not have been possible 10 years ago,
mm-hmm.
7 years ago. A scene like this would have never been possible on screen,
right.
at least on Indian screen. So now we are ready technically, our technicians are now thinking freely, openly and achieving it. And executing it, implementing it. So it was, and I normally, after, from Ram Leela, I started shooting action, and before that there was never any, Sham Kaushal, Sham ji would be called only to say, achha, inko ek thappad maarna, aap jara dekhiye. Wo to kehte, mujhe thappad maarne ke liye bulate ho, aap to koi action to karate nahi ho.
Right.
Then from Ram Leela onwards, I started finding my chemistry with him, and I started enjoying action, and I started shooting it correctly, and he feels very strongly that I shoot action very lyrically. I give it up because I enjoy shooting songs. So
yeah.
that goes into shooting the action.
Right.
And he comes up with ideas which are also very, because then he doesn't, he knows that I don't expect a cliche idea of a war and to shoot it in a certain way. So I think with him, the credit should go to him, the chemistry that I share with him, and he's a fabulous action director. He understands today's cinema and understands today's audience also, how they want to see action differently.
Right.